The South Asia State of Minority Report 2020 says that India has become a dangerous and violent space for Muslim minorities. I'm not saying it. The South Asia State of Minority Report is. So before you jump the gun and call me a Muslim appeaser or accuse me of inciting unrest among Muslims, here are a few hard facts that you should know about the report. The report points out that hate crimes against minorities in the form of mob lynching and vigilante violence against Muslims, Christians and Dalits in particular have seen a spike in the last few years. Not just this report, but there's an additional report by United States Commission on International Religious Freedom, which is USCIRF, in its 2020 report also called India a country of particular concern, CPC, which means a country where government engages in or tolerates particularly severe violation of religious freedom. So let's also take a look at a few other incidents that have been pointed out internationally in the last few years to suggest that India is becoming intolerant. In 2019, 24-year-old Tabrez Ansari was allegedly tied to a pole and thrashed with sticks by a mob in Jharkhand on suspicion of theft. In a video of the incident, he was forced to chant Jai Shri Ram and Jai Hanuman. He succumbed to his injuries just the next day. 2 days after the attack on Ansari, a 26-year-old Muslim teacher was thrown out of a moving train in West Bengal. His name was Hafiz Muhammad Haldar. He was pushed out of the train while the mob chanted Jai Shri Ram. On June 27 last year, a Muslim cab driver, Faisal Usman, was beaten up by a group of men at night in Mumbai. The men once again asked him to chant Jai Shri Ram. This year, the hate crime took the path of pandemic after Tablighi Jamaat was identified as a coronavirus cluster. After that, several false reports of Muslim men deliberately infecting others were circulated in large number. The minority report further says that the BJP strengthened and expanded a series of discriminatory laws and measures that target religious minorities. These include anti-conversion laws, laws that are meant for protection of cow, among others. Now, in December of 2019, an amendment was made to the Citizenship Act of India, and the amendment was passed, which opened the gateway for illegal immigrants from neighboring countries, specifically leaving out only Muslims. The government also announced plans to create a National Register of Citizen, or NRC, for the whole country. But the problem, of course, was not the NRC. The problem was the chronology.
आप chronology समझ लीजिए. पहले CA भी आने जा रहा है. CA भी आने के बाद NRC आएगा और NRC सिर्फ बंगाल के लिए नहीं आएगा. पूरे देश के लिए आएगा. घुसपैठिए देश की समस्या है. बंगाल चूंकि border state है तो बंगाल के लिए ज्यादा acute समस्या है. परंतु पूरे देश की समस्या है. तो पहले CA भी आएगा, सारे शरणार्थियों को नागरिकता दिया जाएगा, तो स्वाभाविक रूप से एनआरसी से उनको भय रखने की जरूरत नहीं।
Now the assurance therefore was that all those who would be excluded from the NRC could make use of the provisions of CAA or Citizenship Amendment Act 2019 for reclaiming Indian citizenship, leaving out only Muslims. Now in Assam, the publication of the draft National Register of Citizen or the NRC in July 2018 to weed out foreigners left over 1.9 million people facing the possibility of mass statelessness. Muslims were feared to be the principal victims of the Assam NRC. Angry protesters, including students who led the anti-CAA NRC protest in Delhi, were met with brute force by authorities. In Assam, the first state to witness the anti-CAA protest, at least 5 people were killed in police firing. In Karnataka, 2 protesters were shot dead by the police. On 15th of December 2019, police forces in the state of UP and in Delhi stormed the campuses of Aligarh Muslim University and Jamia Millia Islamia University in Delhi, the country's 2 premier Muslim institutes or universities. After attacking students with baton, tear gas shells and live bullets, resulting in scores of injuries at both universities, the police detained hundreds of protesters, mainly students. In February 2020, BJP leader Kapil Mishra told the Delhi police to physically vacate an anti-CAA protest site or face consequences. Soon, riots broke out in Northeast District of Delhi. Many other leaders were also heard inciting the people. Several media reports pointed out and revealed the active complicity of Delhi police. The violence resulted in at least 53 deaths, including that of 34 Muslims. However, no action was taken. The report also found that India's civil society actors, which include human rights lawyers, activists, protesters, academics, journalists, have increasingly been under attack for speaking out against the government excesses or majoritarianism. It further says that India's case is unique in terms of alarming setback that have taken place at an extraordinary pace over the course of last few years. So over the last few years, the report says, India has seen a setback when it comes to freedom of minorities, the religious freedom, the freedom to speak up against the government, among others. So not so very good report there that is coming in as far as minority freedom and the rights and liberties that minority enjoys in India is concerned.